We got a heavy question here from a parent who is concerned. They wanted to remain anonymous. This is an email we received. How would you deal with an adult child who is 18 and had an abortion? Mm. Claims to be a Christian, and we are very pro-life, so she's educated in this. I don't know how to really treat her. Any suggestions and prayers are welcomed. Thank you. And Mike, maybe let's start with prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for this family, for this woman, this 18-year-old woman. We ask, God, that you would draw her to yourself, Lord, not knowing the entirety of the situation where she's at right now. We pray that you would bring her to repentance, to see just the heinousness of sin, but also, Lord, the depth of your grace when we turn to you. We pray for her parents, that you would grant them grace also and wisdom, and Lord, a heart of love for their daughter as they navigate this difficult situation. Would you be with them, Lord, and be with us as we think about this together in Jesus' name, amen. Mm-hmm. You know, there are, I believe, a couple of different ways that we need to think about this. One, there's just the element of the church. You know, in the church, when someone who knows better engages in a heinous sin, it really is incumbent upon the leadership, the elders who are watching over the flock, to address the issue with grace, but also with firmness. Now, as I said, a lot depends on how your daughter is responding right now. Is she broken over her sin and looking for God's mercy? Or is she settled in the decision that she made to abort her baby? I mean, if she recognizes that she's sinned, and she hates her sin, well, then I think that the elders should cry with her and give her the gospel with its radical forgiveness. You know, Christ welcomes all those who come to him bowed down because of their sin. But when we stand firm in our rebellion, Jesus has a warning for us. You cannot continue in sin and rebellion and have the peace of Christ. And right now, Jesus calls your daughter, even after her abortion, to himself, to turn from that sin and to cling to his mercy. Now, that doesn't mean that there aren't consequences. You know, abortion is the taking of a human life, and it isn't unforgivable, but there's pain that's associated with it. And I think your daughter needs to have a full sense of the gravity of her sin and also a firm belief in the power of Christ's blood to forgive even this. And let me just say something to the woman listening right now who is in Christ but had an abortion. When you turn to Jesus, his blood is sufficient for you. Our crimes may be great, but his cross is far greater. And that's the hope that we have as followers of Jesus, and that's the hope that we extend to each other and to those who have sinned, even in very grievous ways. And you may feel a sense of betrayal because of how you raised your daughter. You know, that's completely understandable. I think for you, you're going to need to fight to forgive your daughter and to recognize that God, not you, is the primary offended party. Your daughter needs to get right with Jesus, and your gracious example and calling her to turn to him is a part of that. So,
and if she's right with Jesus, then you need to realize she's right with you.
That's right.
You need to forgive her, yeah.
Yeah, so speak the truth and love to your daughter, and at times that truth is difficult, but I think that there is hope, Mike. I mean, we want to say that there's an immense amount of hope because of the power of the gospel.
There's no sin that God cannot cast as far as the east is from the west. And I will remember your sin no more. I'm not even going to remember it. There's a great story that my friend Rod Rosenblatt, pastor and theologian, says that one time a fellow pastor told him a woman came into his study and was just weeping over her abortion. Mm-hmm. And she just began telling him everything that she had done, and she was obviously so remorseful about it. And she thought she had committed the unpardonable sin. She was just going to hell. And he said, I am authorized as an ambassador of Jesus Christ to declare to you now, I absolve you in the name of Jesus Christ of all your sins. You are forgiven. And she says, but what about my abortion? And he said, what abortion? Hmm.
So powerful.
That
yeah.
is how far God goes with this forgiveness.
Yeah.
What abortion.
Yeah.
But you have to come clean about it. You have to acknowledge what it is.
Yeah. Well, it really highlights the importance of having people around us, pastors who can really declare God's forgiveness to us in an yeah. objective way. Because so often when we've sinned, you know, even after we've confessed our sins, we don't feel forgiven. How could God really forgive me? I'm not sure that he could. And so I think that's why Scripture over and over again talks about confessing our sins to each other, confess your sins to one another so that you may be healed. And so that in situations like the one you just mentioned, someone, a brother, can come to us and say, no, on the basis of God's word, you are forgiven.
Yeah.
You may not feel like it.
But here's the objective word.
That's right. Here's the objective word.
Concerning you.
Of the Lord. Amen.